I was very happy to come back after some years to Romania. I was here already in 89 the first time. Then it was this another country. Then I was, but always with great people. And then I became, after your reform started, I became a United Nations Development Program advisor to Romanian government for 2 years. And I was helping to make the first management school, or one of the first management schools here. I tried to help to collect the money from the foreign embassies here for the school, etc., etc. So I was quite connected. And in that time, I spoke quite good. At least I understood everything. I spoke quite good Romanian because I speak French. And I saw that soon we started to get the students to our school. And when Slovenian president visited Romania, I was invited in the delegation, and it was really beautiful and unforgettable because we were in the Chamber of Commerce sitting, and there were like 24, one complete row of Romanian former students there, and they were so much impressing our president that he had to address them specially, etc. So there is a lot of emotion and personal stories about that. And that's why I was so happy to drive again on this boulevard, Avia Torino or something like that, and you know, and to see the new buildings left and right, and see the new things, and to meet old friends, to meet our former students. I would be very happy to now to see who are the ones who were coming. Thank you very much. I'm talking here because I would like to have a tight microphone to walk around, but they will ask me to have a microphone in the hand, but this I don't like. I like to, you know, to make left and right with the hands. So that's why I should be standing here talking. I'm very sorry. It's not really the style of our school. But I would like, first of all, to see who are our students here today, former students. So can you get up that I'm seeing how many are you here today? So please get up. Thank you, thank you. You know, it's not too big number. That only shows, but special greetings, when they're behind is somebody too. My special greetings and kisses to all of you, because we are saying this is the school where the dean is kissing the students. And that is true. I know that you are very busy. We have among the students some very important business people, a member of parliament, etc. We are still waiting to get a prime minister one day, like we have now the Minister of Economic Affairs in Ukraine, Pavlo Sheremeta. He is our doctoral student. We have in many countries around the world people who were graduating in our school or did any of the courses. I agreed with my colleague Natasha, who is a marketing manager, that she will now show the two minutes and a half long film about the school for everybody, for the ones who were in Bled and like to remember the place, which is really one of the nicest lakes in the world, and to invite you to come, and for the ones to come again, and for the ones who never saw it, so that you are getting a feeling which place it is. Then I shall say some words about the school, and then I shall talk about the book Hidden Champions in Eastern Central Europe, which was published in December in Springer in Germany. And it's quite a book, and it's a very good international research that I'm very proud of, because I feel myself not only ambassador of Romania, but also ambassador of Central Eastern Europe. You can be sure that wherever I go, I'm really talking very positively because of the people, you know. Because of the people, because people make the history, people make the future. Wednesday. I was on last Thursday or Friday in Vienna. I don't know anymore, because in the last 2 weeks I was in, you know, in Colombia, in Kenya, in Vienna, and now I'm in Romania. So that's why. Too much, you know, sometimes even for me. And having this conference on hidden champions in Vienna, with the researchers, Hidden Champions, the most innovative companies. We were also meeting the Romanian guy who made the research, and I asked him to be here and to help me to talk also about Romanian most innovative companies, but he couldn't do it, so he was sending me yesterday some update on the Romanian companies, what did they do in the meantime, because we started the research in 2009, and then it was published in 2013. So in the meantime, these companies changed a little bit, but they are still there, and they are still innovative and creating the new jobs. So this will be, I shall be now, as I said, about perhaps 5 minutes talking about the school. Then I shall talk with your questions together about an hour, perhaps a bit less, about the key champions, the most innovative companies in this part of the world. I shall pay some attention to Romania, and then and we shall show this short film in the meantime, and of course I shall be available for any question you might have, and then we shall have a little reception here in behind in the same place, and then I hope that the alumni, the graduates will, everybody will stay here, but I would like also to talk a little bit with the alumni to hear how is their life today and what was that meaning for them. Yesterday I met one of the alumni who couldn't come today here, and he said, "You have to believe me that after I finished the school I didn't have a job, I was looking around what to do, but I had something what I didn't have before, and this was the belief in myself that I can do anything with what I got there, with the network, with the knowledge, with the self-confidence I was getting in this," he said, and then really the career started to develop. So everybody is getting something different, and some, you know, some are saying, my family says that I came from the study, when I came from the study, I became a better human being, which is for me, as a dean, of course, the nicest to hear, you know. So we are very happy to see the career, etc. But if somebody tells you something so intimate, it's a special, I would say, blessing for somebody who is, believing in that already 29 years, because I'm probably one of the oldest deans in the world, you know. There are some older, so I met in the United States, but still, you know, I'm quite a long time there. I made this school, and when the word management was not yet allowed in Slovenia, it was the first management school in the socialist world, and then in the meantime, you know, we were, the school is, you know, having the program still like it was when we started, but many new things, many innovations developed in the meantime, and I shall tell you something about that. So my suggestion is now that Natasha is helping me to show the film. Here is Natasha from the school, here is Manca from the school, here is Professor, young faculty member Ian Sutherland, who was just running, there he is. This is our pianist and the doctor of science who was running the competition. We had a competition with 5 companies that Christy was helping to organize our alumnus. And Stefan Coriano, you know, and so we had a winning team, Coca-Cola, Romania, and of course other 4 companies who were absolutely great. Ian said that he never got such a high level teams, but I'm not surprised because, as I mentioned probably already, every our professor always said, we had great group of students here in Slovenia, but Romanians were the best. So they didn't betray us this time either. So now a short film.